published 17:30 Eastern Standard Time, the 3rd of March 2018, updated 17:30 Eastern Standard Time, the 3rd of March 2018. It is hard to overestimate just what a major moment this is for my old club Tottenham this week against Juventus. Of course, they have been in the Champions League quarterfinals before in 2010-11, when they had a wonderful 3-1 win over Inter Milan in the group stages and then knocked out AC Milan in the last 16. But then they came up against Real Madrid, had Peter Crouch sent off after 15 minutes at the Bernebeu and lost 5-0 on aggregate. Tottenham go into their Champions League second leg against Juventus with a real chance this year, though, if they can get past Juventus, and it's still a big if, they wouldn't necessarily fear anyone in the next round. Even Barcelona and Manchester City have the weaknesses and Tottenham are good enough to exploit them. There is a danger that they think the hard work has been done, with a 2-2 draw in Italy leaving them in a good position for Wembley. However, you can be sure Mauricio Pochettino won't allow the kind of thinking. Harry Kane helped secure a 2-2 draw in Turin, but Tottenham can't think the hard work is done, and obviously they will need to avoid the mistakes that almost cost them the tie at Juventus. For the free kick that led to the opening goal, Jan Vertonghen just slices the ball when normally he puts his foot on it and plays a calmer pass. That's the kind of nervousness that can affect you in such a big game. You're thinking about the magnitude of the game, trying to be safe, but actually you need to play as you normally do. Sloppy marking that accompanied the free kick and the mistakes led to the penalties. So concentration needs to improve. But what will give Tottenham heart is the reaction that followed going 2-0 down after 9 minutes. In fact, it was a performance that will have made the whole of Europe sit up and take notice. It wasn't just that they got back in the game, they dominated it. Juventus couldn't get the ball off them for long periods, and all the scouts there, whether from Barcelona or Bayern Munich, will have been impressed. The last Champions League quarterfinal tie against Real Madrid exposed their limitations, but they have beaten Real Madrid already this season and will fear no one in the quarterfinals. My own feeling is that they have taken so much confidence from beating Real Madrid 3-1 at Wembley that they now know they can take on any team. The FA Cup is still important to Spurs. They need to win a trophy, and they are unlikely to go all the way in the Champions League. There is still the question mark over them from the Chelsea and Newcastle games in 2015-16, when they went to pieces in the Premier League title run-in. They need to answer that, and the best way is with a major trophy. But if by the end of this week they have managed to add last year's Champions League runners-up to the scouts, alongside last year's winners, then the club will know that they have stepped up a level.